Hi friends, it's Wesley. I've been busy lately, but I felt compelled to share some thoughts about KDE Plasma. I originally made my 10 Reasons KDE video because I felt KDE Plasma 5 was a fantastic replacement for the Microsoft Windows desktop experience. Essentially, if you've been using Linux for more than a year, that video really wasn't for you. I never dreamed it would get the amount of views and attention that it got, and I was blown away at the response. So thank you so much for everyone who watched that video. Now this one is for Linux users. Here's 5 reasons you shouldn't use the KDE Plasma desktop. Oh, and quick disclaimer before I start this video, I tend to use the terms KDE, KDE Plasma, and Plasma desktop somewhat interchangeably. I don't need you to correct me, but you can make a fun drinking game out of it if that's your thing. Number 1, you already know you don't like it. Countless people have let me, the rest of this community, know how much they dislike the KDE Plasma desktop. If you know you don't like KDE, why bother watching a video about KDE Plasma features and taking the time to tell others your opinion about a piece of software you opt not to use? While I genuinely enjoy reading the silly arguments and comments of videos, it would be much more valuable for these negative commenters to try KDE on their PC or virtual environment, decide if it's right for them, and if not, simply move on. With all of that said, the comment section of this video is a great place to air your grievances over the KDE Plasma desktop. Number 2, you're using a really low-powered machine like an SBC or Chromebook. I've noticed a trend with the rise of more powerful ARM SBCs, notably the Raspberry Pi boards. These users are expecting a lot out of a sub-$100 system on a chip. If you're intending to run KDE or the GNOME desktop on a low-powered SBC or Chromebook, just know that you're likely using 50 to 75% of its resources at idle alone. For this reason, the ultra-lightweight options such as LXDE, OpenBox with Tent, and tiling window managers like i3 are ideal for low-powered ARM boards. The default Raspberry Pi OS image even ships with a slightly modified version of LXDE. Number 3, you're not willing to deal with the occasional crash. Now this may be purely anecdotal, but I use KDE on almost a daily basis on my Arch Linux machines. In my experience, KDE has always crashed fatally more than any other desktops. This could be related to running bleeding-edge Arch packages, or it could even be some of the software that's running in the background with KDE connecting to my email accounts, etc. But it's noticeable enough for me to mention, and I'm sure I'm not the only one with this experience. Let me know in the comments if you also run into this, and if you found anything that helps. I found the XFCE desktop to be a bit more stable for daily use, but in need of serious configuration to look half as good as KDE Plasma out of the box. Number 4, you prefer a minimal and focused desktop experience. This is another legitimate reason to avoid the Plasma desktop. While the desktop offers workspaces and virtual desktops to separate tasks, I find it all too easy to just open up many applications, leave them running in the background. The notifications for applications I should have closed will send me spiraling out of productivity at any moment. I find it really difficult to come up with a better workspace or virtual desktop layout than i3 or other tiling window managers. People that love using window managers such as these truly love them because they've freed themselves from their poor window hygiene and bad habits that hamper real-world productivity. I happen to be one of those people, especially when I'm writing or programming. The more I can eliminate distractions, the better. This leads smoothly into my next point. Number 5, you prefer to configure your desktop from scratch to include only the software you actually use. If you prefer to configure your desktop experience from the ground up, KDE Plasma is not for you. That doesn't mean you won't use some KDE software though. A perfect example of this is KDE Connect, which allows you to send files back and forth from your computer and phone, with some other neat features like using your phone as a trackpad and keyboard. I've also used KDE Connect countless times to ring my phone when I lose it somewhere around the house. For me, it's a must-have. Let's also not forget, Kden Live is the video editor of choice for most Linux users. There are countless other examples of wonderful KDE software packages that benefit the entire community. If Plasma isn't right for you, that's fine, but it's worth applauding the efforts that KDE developers put into software we all rely on daily. By now, it should be clear, this video isn't about everything wrong with KDE, but rather an effort to set the record straight about what the Plasma desktop is and when you should reach for something else. I've used KDE Plasma for probably longer than any other desktop environment on Linux, and what I love about it is I can install Plasma on any machine running any distro, and I have a great looking, functional, and familiar experience within minutes. There was a time when I enjoyed heavy desktop configuration, but anymore, I find it much more enjoyable to use a desktop that looks great out of the box and get to work immediately. I'm comforted to know that if I really need to focus, I can log into an i3 session with just a couple applications open and get work done. then bounce back to KDE Plasma when I've finished my work and want to make some music or digital art. If you've stuck with me through this short video, thank you again for your time. If this video helped you and you feel like you know someone who would benefit from watching it, please do share it with them. If you haven't already, you can subscribe to this channel and make sure you never miss a somewhat infrequent video, or head over to linuxcreative.com and check out some of the articles there. I also started an email newsletter. If you prefer to get updates in your inbox no more than once a month, you can sign up or opt out of that list at any time from the website. If this community grows, I'll focus my attention more on potentially running a message board or live chat server. In the meantime, I've created a Discord server you can join if interested. See the link in the show notes. See you next time.